I'm with underground tech expert Stefan Burns in Jamaica, peering beneath the surface of pirate Henry Morgan's one-time estate. We're on the hunt for his lost treasure, and it looks like we may have just found a clue.
Dude, I'm seeing tons of stuff up here.
What do you got?
So I wasn't even scanning that long. Look at this. You can see them scattered all throughout this image. That's the one I just rolled over. I saw another one on the other side of that rock, right about here. Yeah, you put them in a line, it's trending this direction.
Well, it's heading right to Morgan's hideout right over there.
Stefan has just revealed an opening beneath the lawn, part of a possible passageway that runs below us. But could this tunnel connect with a larger system, one that could potentially lead from the shore all the way up to the estate? That's what's long been rumored, that Henry Morgan could get to his lookout from the harbor below, using a secret passageway. And if such a network or cavern does exist, could it hold any of Morgan's pilfered gold and silver? Victor, the caretaker, suggests we talk to a neighbor who may have a new lead on another part of this supposed system.
Are you the guy that knows about the tunnels?
Yeah, man.
Tobai has worked on the property for years and is intimately acquainted with its nooks and crannies.
The rumor is that there are tunnels that go from Henry Morgan's estate out to the ocean.
Yeah, man.
And do we know where those tunnel systems are?
Yeah, man, yeah, man.
Could you take us over there?
Yeah, man, no problem.
From what he's seen, he thinks it's more of a cave, but he can take us to the entrance so that we can explore further. This is an unexpected breakthrough.
Up to the cave.
Oh, this is the entrance to the cave?
Yeah, man.
It's little more than a crack in the rock. And until we get in there, I'll have no idea how far the opening goes.
All right.
Time to get skinny.
I got stuck in a cave like this summer. It's probably fine.
I think you're good.
Yeah. You know, the good news is there's no venomous snakes.
I heard there's lots of cave scorpions, though.
Okay.
Here, take mine, too, and then I'm gonna squeeze in there.
Come on down.
All right, see you on the other side. Ugh. Oh, my gosh. This just keeps going.
Almost immediately, the cave begins to open up.
This is like a little crack. You just crawl through, and all of a sudden, this huge cave opens up.
All right, well, let's head down a little bit further, see if we can follow this thing to the exit.
Yeah, we need to see where this goes.
Okay. I think it's right down here. Yeah, I'm going down. All right, Stefan, as you're coming down, just be careful because there is a big drop off right on the other side of your foot there.
Yeah. It
just keeps going.
Okay. So,
you know, if you look around, you can see little tiny entrances all over the place. There's one over there, there's one over this way.
Because of the nature of the limestone rock, there are openings and small caverns scattered all over the place.
There's a giant hole right here, like if you were gonna hide any treasure. I'm gonna try to stick this in here.
Okay.
And there's some giant mole crickets in there. No gold.
There's clearly other cracks and crevices that
really?
You explore. I mean, each one of these little cracks here branches into 10 new ones.
This is absolutely fascinating.
Given their geological features, it's easy to see why caves have been synonymous with hidden treasures throughout history. In fact, they're believed to hold some of the most spectacular collections of riches. The caves of Central Asia's Hindu Kush Mountains reportedly house the fortunes of an 18th century Persian invader, a colossal cache estimated to be worth $500 billion. In India, the bizarre-looking Sonbandar stone chambers are said to hide a secret passage that leads to the royal treasures of an ancient king. But while these riches have yet to be found, a stunning discovery was made in a northern Israeli cave in 2015. A rare collection of jewelry and coins that date back 2,300 years to the reign of Alexander the Great. As we explore this cave, it's also clear that we are not alone.
Oh!
Sounds like you're not a fan of the bat.
No, I don't mind bats. I just don't want them flying in my face. All right, let's keep moving, Stefan. Right. I don't know if Henry Morgan hit any of his gold down here, but if you were wanting a place to hide stuff, this would be a good place for it.
If we could find a connection from here to his hideout, or even just a new tunnel system, I mean, we're golden. We just need to look for it.
I mean, it's clear there's lots of tunnels under these rocks.
Yeah.
Here, I mean, there's probably hundreds and hundreds of tunnels that have yet to be exposed to the surface.
We might need to bust out the technology to help us map this cave fully and all these cracks and crevices.
That's what we're all about.
Stefan has brought along a handheld LiDAR device for just this purpose. It will create three-dimensional renderings of the cave that can be analyzed with precision. So we'll be able to locate any possible connection points to other tunnels that may run up to Morgan's lookout or down to the harbor below. I'm also going to grab the metal detector so we can do a sweep of the cave.
Look at this pile.
Maybe it's a coin.
Could have been. I could have scooped something up. It's in there somewhere.
Stefan keeps digging until...
Hey, I found it.
What is it?
It's a metal cap or something. Almost like a shotgun shell.
Crud.
Look at that.
I thought we had our coin. It's over 100 years old. It's got to be. And if this dates back to 1900, people have had this idea for a long time.
Yeah.
I mean, we went down over a foot to find this thing, which means that if there was gold here, it could be even deeper than that.
Yeah.
Let's see what the 3D LiDAR map has turned up. The rendering is remarkable in its detail. Dozens of small crevices and passages line the walls, making this cave a perfect spot to stash pirate loot. But even more telling is this cave's shape and orientation. Stretching some 30 feet inward, it's positioned in line with both Henry Morgan's old lookout and the harbor. Taken with the evidence of tunnels we found on the top of the hill, could we have finally unearthed proof of a long-lost pirate escape tunnel, one that could have given Henry Morgan direct access to the beach, or a place to store his missing loot? It seems increasingly likely.
Oh, made it! I would say almost guaranteed there's gold down here.
Yeah. And we're getting closer and closer to finding it.